The brain disease Alzheimer's is both fatal and incurable. But in order to develop a treatment, the disease must be detected early. And researcher Oskar Hansson has something in the works.
A dream I have is that in the future we can detect Alzheimer's disease early, before the patients have any disabling symptoms, and that we can then start an effective disease-modifying therapy that really slows down the disease. So no one with Alzheimer's disease in the future will have to develop dementia. Då ska vi säga hallå, hallå, hej!
Hej, hej!
Hej, Oskar Hansson heter jag, hej. Läkare här.
Alf Andersson.
Ja, forskare också. Men du, välkommen, så tar vi och pratar lite och sådär.
Alf Andersson is being examined to see if he has Alzheimer's. It is our most common dementia, affecting both memory and cognitive ability.
Jag har ju svårt att komma ihåg, och när hon frågar saker och ting och så där, så är det ofta tomt.
Just det, ja.
Men ganska vältränad, som man säger.
Ganska och ganska, för guds skull.
Alzheimer's affects the cells deep in the brain. With the disease, a harmful protein, beta amyloid, is created, which settles as small clumps on the nerve fibers in the brain. And another protein, tau, forms as a kind of ball of thread, which sticks together inside the brain's nerve cells. These pathological changes result in the pathways between the nerve cells being blocked. Signals become increasingly difficult to reach different parts of the brain, and the nerve cells eventually atrophy and die. Alzheimer's disease is sometimes called the long farewell, because it slowly leads to death. The changes in the brain can be difficult to detect. When you have symptoms of Alzheimer's disease and come here to the memory clinic, the disease may already have been developing for several years.
Today we only have symptomatic treatments that to some degree improves the memory and attention, but doesn't really stop the disease or slow down the progression.
In order to develop an effective treatment for the disease, Oskar Hansson wants to find a way to detect the disease before it has time to kill too many brain cells.
It was not a difficult choice for me to select Alzheimer's disease, since it's a very common disease that affects the patients a lot, as well as the relatives, but also the society as a whole. Also, since it has been maybe not so recognized before, which was what's also very important for me.
Oskar has been working for 15 years on developing new methods to detect Alzheimer's. Until now, the methods to detect the disease have been expensive, as it is with a PET scan. Or in many countries, they have been considered too complicated, as in, for example, taking samples of spinal fluid. But Oskar's research team has discovered something big.
Är du med, Marie?
Yes.
Så börjar med det gula röret.
Scientists around the world had long been searching for indicators of Alzheimer's in the blood. Oskar's team had now discovered that the protein tau, which in the disease forms the knot in the brain's nerve cells, leaks out into the blood, and the levels were sky high, as much as 7 times more than usual.
So I remember just going to give a talk in Stockholm, and then a colleague of mine, Shirina Janelitze, she just sent me an email, and I checked the email, and then I saw the results of how actually fantastic this new blood test was for identifying Alzheimer's disease. And first I didn't really believe it, but then I checked and asked her, have we done any mistakes? And she said, no, it's correct. And that was one, I think, of the most fantastic events in my career. We actually found something that would make a difference to a lot of patients around the world.
Their results spread around the world. Oskar's team had managed to come up with a both cheaper and better way to reveal the disease so that patients can receive treatment at an early stage. But Oskar also believes there is another positive effect.
It will speed up the development of disease-modifying therapies, especially for the early stages of Alzheimer's disease.
For a long time, dementia has been seen as a part of natural aging, But today, intensive research is underway for possible treatments. However, several times, large drug studies have been conducted and failed. And a main reason for this is that the drugs have thus far been tested on patients who have progressed too far in their disease, and too many nerve cells have already died. But with Oskar's new blood test, the researchers can get into the disease much earlier to reverse the course. So instead of finding it in old age, the test can reveal it already in 25-year-olds.
Det är ju tråkigt om man ska bli sjuk så att säga, men jag får ju hoppas att ni kan hjälpa mig med någonting i så fall, att annars får man ju ta livet som det är, så är det bara.
For Oscar's patient Alf Andersson, the tests will soon reveal whether he suffers from Alzheimer's or not. And for many patients today, it is too late to hope for treatment. But Oskar believes that long-term, the development is looking good.
Now we have very good diagnostics, and actually the first disease-modifying therapy is slowing down the disease or just now emerging. So it has been, I think, very, very pleasant for me to be in this field of research, I must say.